Hello everyone and welcome to this tutorial on interoperability between Rhino and Revit. My name is Oded and today we're going to look at the feature Rhino Assets from Environment for Revit plugin. Before we dive into our project, let's understand why this workflow is so valuable. Rhino 3D is a powerful modeling software known for its flexibility in creating complex freeform shapes and surfaces. Its strength lies in the concept design and handling organic forms, which can sometimes be challenging in Revit. Revit, on the other hand, is a BIM software. It excels at creating detailed data-rich models that are essential for construction documentation and coordination. By combining the best of both worlds, you can leverage Rhino's design freedom and Revit's practical functionalities for a well-rounded architectural workflow. Now let's look at our Rhino model we would like to import. You'll notice the elements are organized into clear layers like topography, paving, stairs, etc. We've also created blocks for repetitive elements like the trees. This structure will make the transfer to Revit more efficient. It's always good practice to verify your model units before moving between softwares. In the unit settings in Rhino, I can see it's set to meters. Let's switch to Revit and begin a new project. To bring in our Rhino model, we'll go to the Environment tab and click on Rhino Assets tool. A window will open up and we can see that currently there are no files loaded in this model. Click Add Rhino File and browse for the Rhino model. Environment should recognize that our model units are also in meters, ensuring a seamless import. Next, choose which layer to import. You can either select all or specify for more control. In our case, we'll use specify to refine our selection. For coordinate system settings and level references, make sure they align with your Revit project. I only have one level here, so it'll reference that by default. It is recommended to keep the group option checked if you anticipate further updates to your Rhino file. It lets you easily reload changes while keeping all your settings in Revit. After hitting OK, you'll see your Rhino layers listed to choose from. Let's exclude the house layer for now and proceed. Environment loads your model into Revit, positioning it correctly based on its origin point. Back in the Rhino asset window, our file is now listed. Expanding it reveals our layers. Notice the house layer is off as intended. And expanding each layer reveals elements in that layer. The Show Preview option offers a helpful visualization window of your model. Let's start by importing topography from Rhino as native Revit elements. After clicking the plus sign to expand the layer, I see I got several topography elements. I select the ones I want to designate as existing topography. Then click on the three dots icon. Here I can select the import category. I will choose Toposolid. And since I want it to be a native editable Revit element, I will check the apply system family. I'll also select the type existing ground and I can also set instances parameter down here. For example, I'll change the face created parameter to existing. Now let's have a look at this topography element modeled as a solid in Rhino. We'll set it as paving stones. The process is the same, three dots, choose topo solid, apply system family and the appropriate type, paving stones. We'll leave all the other settings as default since this is a new construction. Click OK to confirm these changes and again to see the model in our Revit model space. We can see that the surfaces are now toposolids that are fully editable in Revit. I'll repeat the same process for the paving, but this time I will use the floor category. Back in our Rhino Assets window, let's import our trees as native Revit families. Expand the trees layer, and because we used blocks in Rhino, note that you'll only see one row of the block here and the number of instances is marked in brackets. Click the three dots icon, and this time replace with Revit family. I will choose this tree from the Revit library. I click on OK, and the Rhino tree blocks should now be replaced with Revit families. Before moving on, a quick note. At the time of recording, elements like stairs and walls can only be imported into Revit as direct shapes and not system families. meaning they are not editable in Revit. Let's move on and import our stairs and walls. For this example, you can change the category of the entire layer to stairs or walls right here, respectively. Finally, let's turn this unique bench that was designed in Rhino into a Revit family. Go to the bench element in the bench layer, click the three dots, and replace with Revit family. This time we'll create a new family. Let's name it Bench from Rhino. I will set the category to furniture. And since I like the red color of this bench in my Rhino, let's keep Rhino display color as the material. Click OK to create the family. Now you have a native Revit bench that you can place and modify as needed in your Revit space. Now, what if you make changes to your Rhino model? Here you can see I'm adjusting the topography and modifying the tree's amount and position in my Rhino model. After you're done modifying it, save the file in Rhino, head back to Revit's Rhino Assets window, and now let's look at this menu next to the file name in the Rhino Assets window. It has several useful options. I will start bottoms up. Set group workset. Assigns a group to a specific workset within your Revit project. The set group parameters option lets you modify parameters specific to the group of elements from your Rhino file. Ungroup. In case you had the Rhino model as a group, this will ungroup it. But remember, in order to use the reload options, your Rhino model must be grouped. Remove. This deletes the Rhino file from your Revit project. Reload from. Use this if you want to replace the path of the original Rhino file while keeping your preferences. And reload. If you make changes in your original Rhino file, use reload to update the version in Revit. Environment will remember your previous choices and apply them, saving you lots of time. This demonstrates a fantastic workflow, empowering you to iterate quickly between the two software seamlessly. That's it. I hope you see the power of combining Rhino and Revit. Leave a comment if you have any questions or remark, and thank you for watching. If you want to learn more, please like and subscribe this video.